Okay, so today we're going to look at some visuals. So with all my behaviors, whether it's obedience, agility, or tricks, is I use visuals, okay? So with every single behavior, if you haven't already, you should be getting visuals put into them. So I'm going to show you a variety of my visuals and how you'll start to pair them with the behavior. So for example, just a simple sit. So sit, yes. So he can do it on visual and verbal. Yes, and there's my visual for sit. You can choose any visual, any verbal for any behavior, as long as you pair them correctly. So if you've not paired a visual with a behavior, what I want you to start to do is literally have your verbal sit, yes, and do the visual at the same time. Cool, okay. Sit, yes. Good, okay. Sit, yes, okay. And then I want you to start to mix it up by sometimes just saying sit, yes, good, okay. And then I want you to sometimes just do the visual, yes, okay, good. What you can do is you do the less obvious to the dog first. So for example, if I did my visual and he didn't sit, I'd then say sit, okay? So let me do that again. So I'm just tricking him at the moment, but yeah, so I do my visual first, and if he didn't do it, I'd then say sit, yes, okay. So you're giving them a chance to understand what the visual actually means before you help them out with the verbal, if that makes sense. So again, yes, this is sit, good, okay. And for me, this is down. Yep. Good boy. And it's the same with any behavior. Okay, so I'll just do a few of mine. Yes, good boy. Good boy. So you can see you don't have to say anything, which is great, right? We always talk way too much. So what I want you to do is with every trick you're doing, and you do need about 10 hands sometimes, once they know the trick, however you've been teaching it, make sure you've got a really good visual on it so you don't have to say anything. And the more less obvious, I guess, the visual is, the more it looks like a trick. Yeah. So you want to get them as subtle as possible, really. The same with spinning, really. You don't really want to do your arms out really big like this. You want to make it a lot smaller. Yes, good. And even that, you can make it a much smaller visual. And again, you just work at it. So you'd start off by doing a really big, obvious visual for your dog. Yes. Okay. And then make it a little bit smaller. Yes. Okay. Yes, good. So you start off big, make sure that they 100% know that, and then you start to make the visual a little bit smaller. So you can start to pair them with the behaviors. Yes, good boy. Good boy. Cool, so have some fun with it. Get those visuals going.